lineage goes to 100 years back, when my great-great-grandfather, Dr. Gunwantraya Agarwal, who was allopath doctor and close associate of Swami Shivananda. And that legacy was transferred to my father, who was a great Vaidya. Vaidya means a doctor of Ayurveda medicine. And that legacy was transferred to us, me, my wife, and then to fourth generation, Yogi Dr. Amrit Raj and Dr. Arjun Raj. And thereafter it was transferred to Maa Yoga Ashram, which is run by Yogi Dr. Amrit Raj and family. And Arogyadham. Arogyadham is a well-known family health magazine, which is read by more than 70 million people in India and across the world. Maa Yoga Ashram, Arogyadham, Tapovan, Rishikesh is a holistic treatment center where we, whatever we practice, we adapt it. We don't look peace outside. We see peace inside. So we don't care for external hygiene. We care for internal hygiene. So we don't keep RO in kitchens. We keep RO here. And our remote is in our hands, not in others' hands. Means our happiness or unhappiness is not governed by any other person. It's governed by ourselves. So we try to keep our mind clean as much as we can, by virtue of meditation, by virtue of yogic practices, by virtue of Ayurvedic herbal extracts.
What happens inside that makes us so happy?
Have you seen musk deer? The deer which lives in high altitudes.
Yeah.
It has a special musk which is in the umbilicus. It runs after the fragrance to look after from where it is coming. Although he doesn't know, it is coming from within him. In the same way, the peace is never outside. It's not in materialistic gains. Materialistic gains may be our means. Those means cannot be our ends. In Patanjali Yoga Sutras, these sutras means sentences, were written 5,000 years back. Last year we had a special guest here, Ambassador of Czech Republic. Earlier you must be knowing Czechoslovakia was a communist country. When he came to ashram, he said, why should we meditate? It's just wastage of time. I explained him medically. I could understand why he is raising this question. I said, earlier your country was a communist country. You must be a communist. That's why you are raising this question. I explained him medically, do you know how much heart rests? He said, no. I said, heart rests double the time it works. When it contracts, it gets tight. When it expands, it relaxes itself. Then I asked him, do you know mind, how mind takes rest? He said, no. Then I said, mind works during sleep also. When you sleep, do you remember anything? Do you remember any bank accounts? No. Who is in contact with the body? Your consciousness. And this consciousness in English is called spirit. In Bhagavad Gita, we call it soul. In Vedas, we call it Om. Increasing our consciousness level is the ultimate aim and object of meditation. Why Gautam Buddha meditated? Why Guru Gobind Singh meditated for 12 years? What was the need? To increase their conscious level. Eating, sleeping, drinking, this is done by each and every animal. What is the difference between us and animals? They have a fixed wisdom. They cannot develop their wisdom. Just see any animal. They follow that rule which is given to them. All other animals, they follow the same rule. They cannot increase their consciousness level. They cannot increase their wisdom. They cannot increase their happiness. But we are so destined by divine, the great divine soul, that we have been given everything. We have been given hands to give. We have been given legs to walk. We have been given mind to think, to increase our intellect, which other animals not have been given. In spite of the fact, if we complained, who is at fault? We are at fault. Count our blessings. We never count our blessings. 3 months back, I saw a patient in Haridwar. He lost his eyesight 10 years back when he was to be operated. Ask him what he needs in life. He needs vision. If somebody doesn't have legs, ask him what he needs. When he has given us everything, now our aim and object is how to lead our life in a balanced way. Have you heard the name of Lord Rama?
No.
Ramcharitmanas, a great lord in India, in Indian history. We worship him. But you will be surprised, all his life, he had miseries with his life. He was crowned as a king, but he was not a king even for a day. Just after getting kingdom, he was asked by his family members to go to jungles because of family problems. He was in jungle for 14 years. He got married. He never enjoyed married life. He had 2 sons. He could not enjoy their father-son's relationship. When his wife, they were all together, his wife was kidnapped. When he brought wife back, somebody said ill, he kicked her out. But all the time, he was same. Why we worship him? Because he was balanced in all circumstances. Our all, scriptures, what they say, keep your mind, keep your body, keep your soul balanced in all circumstances. We should not run. Just 2 months back, Amrit had a lecture in a very famous college in Delhi, Jesus and Mary. It's a famous college of commerce. Very famous college. What he said, the college can tell you how to open the accounts, banking accounts, but they can never tell you how to open the peace account, happiness account, bliss account. How many Westerners, how many Indians even too, they take care of their parents? If they don't take care of their parents, they are likely to have the same fate. Then they will have frustration. Isolation, I've seen in America, Once we went to America to see a special class. Still today, they don't go to schools. They don't use electricity. They never move by vehicles. And they are not in very small numbers. They are more than 50 lakhs. Can you tell me that class? They are Amish people. You might have seen, we have seen their houses, how they live. They are pure Catholics. They migrated at the time of Christ from Switzerland, from south of Germany, nearby Spain, the adjoining area of middle area of Europe, and they still practice it. They are free, they don't use even electricity, and they are the happiest. So it means happiness is not in the things we are looking into. It is within us. That's why in Gautam Buddha, you know, Lord Buddha, he said, grow yourself from inside to out. In Sikh religion, there is a book, holy book, Guru Granth Sahib. They have said, Aape Guru, Aape Chela. You are yourself your own guru. You are yourself your own disciple. Follow your consciousness. Follow yourself. So we follow these norms of life. What to do, what not to do. And yoga, Ayurveda, meditation, this all helps us to balance ourselves. I know if I earn more money, I'll be losing my precious time of enjoying. And that money will not be used by me. How much a money can be used by an individual every day? Just tell me. Rest of the money, what happens? It creates more problems. Instead of giving you more peace. Just see, Hilton family, what they did.
Yeah.
Why they donated whole property? They have seen all these things, what happens within the family when you have big money. So, our Vedas, they have provided every answer for it.
Where to start? How does someone start?
I had my first press conference in United States on 19 June 1995.
Wow.
I'll speak on that, you know.
Yeah. Okay.
And that conference was organized by ourselves in National Press Club building, Washington, D.C. And my topic was, you are killing your own generation by your own trade tactics. I gave 20 examples where Americans, in the name of science, they are cheating their own society. Right? First, I gave the example of hair oil. Hair oils.
Yeah.
All the hair oils in the market which are being sold, they are prepared from LLP. Light liquid petroleum. And what is that? That is the waste product of kerosene oil.
Wow.
And they have given the fictitious name to that, white oil. When they take out the smell of LLP, they have given a name which doesn't exist in medical books. White oil. Just tell me what oil is. Oil is which is greasy. Mustard oil, coconut oil, sesame oil, just see. Anything which is greasy is known as oil. Anything non-greasy cannot be oil. They put one drop of any essence and they say this is oil. And our young generation, they say, no, oil should not be greasy. You know, external nourishment to hair is highly needed and it's provided always by oil. Internally, hair gets nourishment from the blood. Externally, it gets from the oil. And with the oil which we are using, in the multinational companies are using, is not an oil. And who is using it? Our generation is using. And who is at fault? We are at fault. Is it right? Second example I gave, the Coca-Cola. You know the highest value of in Coca-Cola? The cork which we throw. What it contains? Artificially flavored carbonated water contains no fruit juice. I said, why you are not promoting juices? Natural juices. Why you are promoting this Coca-Cola? You know the budget of a Coca-Cola company? bigger than any country's budget. Mm. It's run by more than 300 well-trained corporates in a single unit. And who is using it? We all are using it. Mm. Then I gave the example of fast food. What is fast food? Just tell me. Is fast food is a fast food for a cook who cooks it. Mm. For a person who eats it, it's a late food. It takes more time to travel in the intestine. More time in digestion, more time in metabolism, more time in excretion. Mm. You know the real cause of cancer? Chronic irritation. Anything which irritates any organs for years together leads to cancer. Mm. If that food travels late and we eat fast food, what will happen? Our esophagus, our stomach, small intestine, large intestine, rectum, the internal mucosa will be irritated. Mm. Internal cells will be irritated. And if the process goes on for years together, it leads to cancer. Fourth example I give of, you know, wine. How they make English wine? From raw materials?
Yeah.
More essence. Why English names? What is wine and whiskey? Mm. More scent, more perfumes, more essence. And you know what it damages? Liver cells. And the weight of the liver, you know? 1200 grams. 1.2 kg. Mm. Who is going to be affected? Human beings are going to be. Then I gave the example of smoking. You know the weight of the lungs? Right lung, 1200 grams. Left lung, 800 grams. Combined together, 2 kg. How much? 2 kg. If we smoke, just tell me a single benefit of smoking. You know, in Guru Granth Sahib, they have prohibited forbidden not to smoke. Why? The gurus were so intelligent. If we smoke, we are likely to lose our vital capacity. The lungs provide vital capacity of the body. Mm. You see, by smoking, we are injuring our lung cells. We are making ourselves more weakened. So these are the things, and if you know, I quote you example of Einstein. You know, he was kicked out of the school. You know it?
Yeah.
He was kicked out of the school because he used to raise many questions in the school. And teachers were tired of him. They made a conspiracy against him, and they asked the principal to take him out. The principal wrote a letter to his mother, that he is such a stupid boy, we cannot teach him. But mother said to his son, when he received the letter, she received the letter, you are so intelligent that school cannot teach you.
Hmm.
But when mother died, one day, after some years, he was looking for something, he found that letter.
Hmm.
He was surprised to see it. Then he could understand. Everybody has same mental faculties. It's only how we grow itself. Just see, I learned many things from the nature. Last time when President Obama came, Amrit gave him 20 minutes one-to-one session.
Wow.
He asked one question, is rebirth possible or not? He answered from this book, Patanjali Yoga Sutra. There is one shloka. Bhav pratyo videhi prakriti laryam. The meaning of bhav pratyo is rebirth is caught. Videhi means when you rise above bodily attachments. And Prakriti Lalayam means get this answer from the nature. Please, can you read it?
Those who merrily leave their physical bodies and attain the state of celestial deities, or those who get merged in nature have rebirth.
I'll explain you. Just see, you just see any tree, you just see any crop,
yeah.
anything grown in the nature. Nature asks them to grow at one place. They are not allowed to move anywhere.
Mm.
The seed goes into the sea, in the earth, Mother Earth. It grows there. It grows. And when it blossoms, every branch has a fruit and every fruit has a seed in it. And that seed regrows. In the same way, this which we think body, it's not only body, it's body, mind and soul. When we die, this soul, which is called consciousness, takes another birth. Body dies, mind dies, soul never dies.
Mm.
So, if you want to know this thing, that rebirth is possible or not, get this answer from the nature.
Mm.
And nature has provided every answer. That's why we call it Ayurveda as a science of natural well-being. Western people, they take care of their physical bodies, but mental body health they don't care of. They think they can do many things together. They are mistaken. After all, body is a body. It contains 5 liters of blood. It comes to heart 72 times in a minute. You multiply it by 60, you multiply by it by 24. This is a natural phenomena of the body. It has a certain limit. It can bear certain pressures. It cannot bear undue pressures. It needs a family. If one doesn't have a family, they cannot enjoy. Everybody needs a family. Just see animals, they have a family. They live together, they fly together, they share everything together. Secondly, I'll quote this shloka. Paramanu param mahatva te anto asya vashyakarika. Paramanu means the primal atom, smallest atom. Science knows the power of primal atom only since last 100 years. But our rishis and munis, they were knowing power of this paramanu, primal atom, 5000 years back. These sentences were written not by me, by well-known rishis and munis 5000 years back. And they have written the word paramanu. Paramanu means the primal atom. Param mahatam means greatest magnitude. Te means his, anto means in the end. Vashikarek means the gradually mastery in concentration. Can you read it?
Gradually, one's mastery in concentration extends from the primal atom to the greatest magnitude.
Just see, the science says primal atoms contain so much energy. If we concentrate at some point for years together, gradually, not in a year, in a day. That's why I said I meditated for half an hour in the morning. If we meditate regularly for years together, it leads to highest magnitude, means highest success. All these scientists, modern day scientists, they are great rishis and munis. They focused at one point and they go deep into it. They are modern day scientists. They were ancient day scientists, the only difference.
Every step I take, like coming here, meeting lovely people, speaking to you, it's all like I find the magic of simplicity.
Yes.
And
you're very correct.
Yeah. And yeah.
Great.
I think I should record myself.
Yes. Very great word you said.
And especially going to less, you know, and going to less things.
Yes.
Gives more space.
Yes.
To grow bigger.
Yes.
Inside. That's what I've learned these months, and it's. Yes, and it's so fulfilling.
Yes.
Disease, dullness, doubt, carelessness, laziness, sensuality, false perception, failure to reach firm ground and slipping from the ground gained, these distractions of the mind, stuff, are obstacles.
Not be fear of anybody. So, forget your past, always future is a mystery, always try to remain in present, enjoy your present moments.
Yes.
And every failure, every wrong thing is blessed with higher success. Just see the example of Nelson Mandela. He was in jail for 27 years. So nothing is impossible in life.
That's marvelous.
Yes. Thank you. My regards and my gratitude for everything.